well, all is well. Angels and men rejoice, for tonight darkness fell into the dawn of love light. Sing on.
Hail, Holy Mother, who gave birth to the King, who rules heaven and earth forever. God is for us a refuge and strength, an ever-present help in the time of distress. So we shall not fear though the earth should rock, though the mountains quake to the heart of the sea. Hail, Holy Mother, who gave birth to the King, who rules heaven and earth forever. The waters of a river give joy to God's city, the holy place, the dwelling of the Most High. God is within it, cannot be shaken. God will help it at the dawning of the day. Hail, Holy Mother, who gave birth to the King, who rules heaven and earth forever. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Hail, Holy Mother, who gave birth to the King, who rules heaven and earth forever.
Good morning. Happy New Year. Welcome to our celebration of Mary, the Mother of God. This Mass is being offered for Margarita Blanco. Since there's so few of us, We'll do communion like we do our daily Mass. So if you'll just move towards the aisle that's ahead of the kneeler, it'll be closer for you. Our opening song is Angels We Have Heard on High. Please stand.
Good morning. Today we are celebrating the feast of Mary, Mother of God. And today, as we begin the new year, a strange way to begin with all the snow. But still, no, we trust in God. Every time I see snow falling from the sky, I think of God's blessings. Maybe it's hard for most of us to drive the snow. But we receive everything from God's hand as his blessings. And today let's ask God to be with us, to be with the year ahead, 2021, that we might be blessed richly by God, that Mary, our mother, whose feast we celebrate today, the motherhood of Mary, intercedes for us for all the blessings that we need. And now we shall begin our Mass. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let's ask God to forgive our sins and make us worthy to celebrate this Eucharist.
Lord Jesus, your mighty God and Prince of Peace, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Son of God and Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are Word made flesh and splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Thank you.
Let us pray. O God, who through the fruitful virginity of Blessed Mary bestowed on the human race the grace of eternal salvation, grant, we pray, that we may experience the intercession of her through whom we were found worthy to receive the author of life, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Numbers. The Lord said to Moses, "Speak to Aaron and his sons and tell them, 'This is how you shall bless the Israelites. Say to them, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord let his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you kindly and give you peace.' So shall they invoke my name upon the Israelites, and I will bless them." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And bless us, and let your face shed its light upon us. So will your ways be known upon earth, and all nations learn your salvation. May God bless us in his mercy. May God bless us in the nations be glad and shout for joy. With a brightness you rule the peoples. You guide the nations on earth. May God bless us in his mercy. May God bless us in his mercy. Let the peoples praise you, O God. Let all the peoples praise you. May God still give us his blessing, that all the ends of the earth may revere him. May God bless us in his mercy. May God bless us in his mercy.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Galatians. Brothers and sisters, when the fullness of time had come, God sent his Son, born of a woman, born under the law, to ransom those under the law, so that we might receive adoption as sons. As proof that you are sons, God sent the Spirit of his Son into our hearts, crying out, "Abba, Father." So you are no longer a slave, but a son. And if a son, then also an heir through God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
In the past, God spoke through the prophets. Now he speaks to us through his Son. From the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The shepherds went in haste to Bethlehem and found Mary and Joseph and the infant lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known the message that had been told them about this child. All who heard it were amazed by what had been told them by the shepherds. And Mary kept all these things, reflecting on them in her heart. Then the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had seen and heard, just as it had been told to them. When 8 days were completed for his circumcision, he was named Jesus, the name given him by the angel before he was conceived in the womb. The Gospel of the Lord.
Three important events. The first, New Year. No matter who we are, either Catholics, Christians, non-believers, everyone celebrates the beginning of a new year. And the first month in New Year we call January. This name has come from a Greek god called Janus. And Janus has two faces, one to look ahead and one to look back. Indeed, the first month, especially the first day, we need to look back, 2020. I'm sure for most of us, it is not a happy, joyful year. A strangest year in all our life. The whole world has to fight with this pandemic, COVID-19. The loss that it created, both financially, lives, and confusion in the world, and the number of times we miss coming together to celebrate the Eucharist. It was not a very happy year. Yet, if we closely examine and see, we have so many things to be thankful to God for 2020. As families, we spend more time together. Probably there are so many other personal things in which God has blessed us in spite of the problems and challenges that we have. We are very happy to say goodbye to 2020. And we have 1 year ahead, 2021. It seems to be bright, hopeful, especially with the fight that we had with COVID-19. It seems to be bright. We have vaccine. And more than that, we have 1 year of time ahead. All the other things that we have in life, we can earn, buy, or borrow. Time is one thing that we cannot buy, borrow, or buy. Even an hour of time is valuable. Talk to people who are in hospital. How valuable the time is. And God is showing us 1 year, 2021, as the Greek god Janus We should look back, learn some lessons, and look ahead with hope and trust in God as we celebrate the new year. As I said, time is the most valuable thing that we can have, and God has given us a free 365 days. How many hours? 525,600 hours or minutes. God has given us so much of time. Let's be thankful. God, we know that we had a challenging year last year, but we know that with you and with your help, we hope to have a joyful, fruitful, blissful year ahead. And the second feast is for all of us Catholics, the Solemnity of Mary, the Mother of God. Today the Church celebrates the motherhood of Mary. She is truly the Mother of God, there's no doubt about it. Because that's what the angel told her. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great, and he will be called Son of the Most High. There will not be end for his kingdom. The angel has told Mary, the one that she has to conceive and bear and give birth will be truly the Son of God. And after that, Mary went to visit Elizabeth. When Elizabeth saw Mary coming towards her, Luke in his gospel, he says, Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit. And she was talking with the inspiration of the Holy Spirit. And she said, how does this happen to me, that the mother of my Lord come to me? The mother of my God come to me. So Mary was truly the mother of God because Jesus was truly man and truly God. Especially the first few centuries, there was confusion. There was some claiming that Mary is only the mother of a human being called Jesus, not Son of God. But in the year 341, at the Council of Ephesus, they came together, and this was one of the important topics they were discussing and they wanted to decide about. There were so many people waiting outside to listen to what the church would say. After the council, they came out and said, Mary is truly the mother of God. And it seems all the people who were there, hundreds and thousands of people, when they heard this, they were so joyful, they ran to the streets proclaiming, Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. That's how we have the second half of Hail Mary. Mary was truly the Mother of God, and today we celebrate. It is not enough just to celebrate Mary as Mother of God and our mother. What do we learn from her? And we all want, there's so many mothers here. You want your children, your son, your daughter, to learn all the best from you. And what do we have to learn from Mary? Very important. Yes to God's will. No matter what happens. Yes to God's will. When she had to become pregnant, she said yes to God's will. When Jesus has to leave her and go to preach, she said yes to God's will. When she saw Jesus carrying the cross, completely bruised, beaten and bleeding, she said yes. When Jesus was hanging on the cross, she was standing at the foot of the cross, she said yes. Today as we celebrate the motherhood of Mary, let us learn to say yes to God's will. Let's not be afraid of what happens. When Mother Mary appeared in Guadalupe, this is what he told him. I am your mother. Sorry, I am here. I am your mother. Do not fear. I am near. That's what I'm sure every mother would tell her children. I am here. I'm your mother. Do not fear. I am near. And that's what Mother Mary is giving us today as we begin the new year. I am here. I'm your mother. Do not fear. I am near. She intercedes for us. She is not the goddess, but she is Mother of God. She intercedes. We have a wonderful example at the wedding at Cana when there was no wine. No one told her. She observed. She went and asked her son, "Son, they have no wine." Let Mary intercede for us this year. And third feast, naming of Jesus. Name is a very powerful thing. We read in St. Paul's letter to Philippians, at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bend in heaven, on earth, and under the earth. That's why every time you hear a priest praying, he always concludes saying, "We ask this in the name of Jesus, our Lord." All the prayers has been directed to God in the name of Jesus, because Jesus himself told in John's Gospel, chapter 14, verse 13, "Whatever you ask in my name, it shall be given to you." The name of Jesus. We have a wonderful example in Acts of the Apostle. After the death of Jesus, Peter and John, they go to Jerusalem temple. There was a person begging at the steps, hoping to get from Peter and John. He extends his hand. "Can I have something?" And Peter said, "Neither silver or gold we have." We don't have silver or gold. "But in the name of Jesus, rise up and walk." He got up, jumped, and walked. That is the power of the name of Jesus. That name has been given to us today, the naming of Jesus. We heard in the gospel, on the eighth day, he was named Jesus, the name which was told to Mary and Joseph even before he was born. So today, dear brothers and sisters, as we celebrate these three important events and feasts, New Year, let us not be afraid. Mary is near. Let us not be afraid. The name of Jesus is given to us. Let us trust in Jesus and in the intercessions of Mary and begin this new year with hope and joy that God will be with us always. We shall all stand and pray, profess our faith. I believe in one God. The Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who is the Father and the Son.
I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Trusting in God our Father, as we begin this new year, let's ask for our needs and the blessings that we need in our life.
The congregational response is, Lord, hear our prayer. May Pope Francis, Archbishop Paul, and all the leaders of the church, under the patronage of Mary, bring people closer to Christ, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us at St. John the Baptist, may this next year be one of healing and new beginnings, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who experience heavy burdens in their lives find comfort and peace in the Blessed Mother, who knows their pain, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May our sick and lonely know love and peace through the prayers of our Blessed Mother, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God our Father, welcome into your presence our departed brothers and sisters who have died this last year. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all of our personal prayers, all the prayers we've prayed before the Blessed Sacrament, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray. God, our loving Father, with your trusting in you, as we begin this new year, we ask that you be with us and guide us, that we might be protected from all harm and all the difficulties that we may have to face, and we may have a joyful and fruitful year ahead. We ask this through Christ our Lord. And sisters, that this my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
O God, who in your kindness begin all good things and bring them to fulfillment, grant us who find joy in the solemnity of the Holy Mother of God, that just as we glory in the beginnings of your grace, so one day we may rejoice in its completion, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, to praise and bless and glorify your name on the solemnity of the motherhood of the Blessed Virgin Mary. For by the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, she conceived her only begotten Son, and without losing the glory of virginity, brought forth into the world the eternal light, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him the angels praise and your majesty. Dominions adore, powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together in exaltation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim. Holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather your people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, your pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we were nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with the elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with the blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the blessed apostles, glorious martyrs, and all the saints, on whose constant intercessions in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, Paul, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, to our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life. Give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Pray for the coming of God's kingdom as Jesus taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come,
thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses,
as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation.
Deliver
us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of Jesus Christ be with you always. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, I shall also be healed. For the Holy Communion, just me and Deacon will be distributing the body of Christ from where you find kneelers. And Joel, you could go up to the balcony. Bye.
this baby in my arms, sleeping now so peacefully. The Son of God, the angel said, how could it be? Lord, I know he's not my own, not of my flesh, not of my bones. Still, Father, let this baby be the son of my love. Father, show me where I fit into this plan of yours. How can a man be father to the Son of God? Lord, for all my life I've been a simple carpenter. How can I raise a king? How can I raise a king? He looks so small, his face and hands so fair. And when he cries, the sun just seems to disappear. But when he laughs, it shines again. How could it be? Father, show me where I fit into this plan of yours. How can a man be father to the Son of God? Lord, for all my life I've been a simple carpenter. How can I raise a king? How can I raise a king? How could it be this baby in my arms, sleeping now so peacefully? The Son of God, the angel said, how could it be? How could it be?
Pray to St. Michael the Archangel. St. Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray, and do thou, O Prince of Heavenly Host. Seeking the ruin of souls.
Today, after the Mass, we will not have the adoration because of the bad weather. And tomorrow, Saturday, we will not have, and Sunday too, but we will begin from Monday. Let's all stand for the final blessing. Let us pray. We have received this heavenly sacrament with joy, O Lord. Grant, we pray, that it may lead us to eternal life, for we rejoice to proclaim the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of your Son and Mother of the Church, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Bow down for the blessing.
May God, the source and origin of all blessing, grant you grace, pour out his blessings in abundance, and keep you safe from harm throughout the year.
Amen. Amen.
May he give you integrity in the faith, endurance in hope, and perseverance in charity, with holy patience to the end.
Amen.
May he order your days and your deeds in his peace. Grant your prayers in this and in the every place, and lead you happily to the eternal life.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.